Good morning, everyone. Already we have started water. Okay, on that. Now let me see about water cycle. Okay, what do you mean about the cycle? So what is cycle here? So water cycle is right from the rainfall. We are getting water. Okay. So they used to store in the streams. Okay. Streams will be either big or small. Okay. Right from there they used to convert into the ponds and next to rivers and rivers to oceans and also seas. Okay. This is the cycle what we know about water. Okay. Some of the rainwater seeps into the ground and becomes groundwater. Also, some water seeps into the ground and they form groundwater. Okay. So, water droplets are coming from the clouds. Okay. Those water droplets convert into water and form streams, either bigger or smaller one. And next, they also form ponds, rivers, oceans, seas, and also some water seeps into the ground. So such is known as groundwater. Okay. As it is very hot during summer, large quantity of water evaporates from seas, lakes, rivers, etc. and converts into water vapor. Okay, in the summer season, large amount of water is getting evaporated from the ocean, seas and from lakes. Okay, these water are getting evaporated. So such and converts into water vapor, thus this give up into the air to form clouds. Okay, this water vapor again combines with air to form clouds. Okay, next step. These clouds again cool and give rain. So again these clouds will become cool and they used to give rain to us. Okay, the circulation of water between earth surface and air is called water cycle. Okay, what he is saying, that circulation of water between earth surface. So it is also called as hydrological. So hydrological cycle is also known as hydrological cycle. So the circulation of water around or between the earth surface and air is called as hydrological cycle or water cycle. Okay. The water cycle can be summarized as follows. It has four stages. This water cycle is having direction.
Before that, precipitation consists of four types.
precipitation. Okay. Each type begins as whether either water droplets or ice crystals in clouds. Okay. Each type begins as either water droplets or ice crystals in the clouds. Rain. Rain falls when the air temperature are above freezing. When the temperature is above freezing, we use it to see rainfall. Okay. Sleet occurs when raindrops fall through freezing air near earth surface. The drops turn into pellets of ice. Okay. What happening when these raindrops through the freezing air, it converts into the ice. Okay. Snow falls when water vapor passes through air that is very cold. As a result, the water vapor crystallizes and builds into snowflakes. Okay. These snow, when water vapor passes through the air that is very cold, as a result water vapor crystallizes in the form of snow. Okay. Hail forms when thunderstorm winds push water back up into the atmosphere. The water which turns into ice is coated with more water and pushed up to freeze again. The process repeats until the hailstone is heavy enough to fall. Okay, what happening here? These thunderstorms and wind pushes water back into the atmosphere. Okay, after that the water turns into the ice and it is coated with more water, and finally the hailstone becomes freeze, and when it becomes heavy, finally it drops from the surface of the clouds. Okay.